Welcome to Printful's Design Series, where we'll show you practical tips that you can use to create awesome designs for print-on-demand products. This episode will be about vectorization. By the end of this video, you'll learn how to make this out of that. Vectorization is a process where your bitmap or raster image that consists of pixels is made into a vector that consists of shapes. What's great about vector images is that no matter how you change their size, they won't lose quality, as opposed to a bitmap image that'll only get worse when the scale exceeds its original size. Vectorization can help you create elements that can be used in designs for many different sized products. For this task, I'll use Adobe Illustrator. I'll open an image with a transparent background. As you can see, the image doesn't take up all the space on the canvas. Vectorization requires processing power, and keeping the image at its current size can reduce the strain on the system. Next, I'll go to Window and click on Image Trace. A new window will open up where I can adjust the settings to convert my image into a vector. The first two lines contain presets, which are based on the advanced settings below. We'll ignore them for now. When I go to View, I can switch between different options of how I want to see the result of the image trace. By pressing on the eye icon located next to it, I can view the original image. You'll see how it works later in the video. Under Mode, I can choose if I want my vectorized image to be made of colors, shades of gray, or black and white. I'll select Color, and with that, a new palette panel becomes available. Palette gives me the options to set the color range of my vector. The limited option narrows down the number of colors, making them easily manageable, while Full Tone gives me a wide range of colors based on my image, which makes it hardly recognizable as a vector when looked from afar. The color slider allows me to set a specific number of colors to be included in the final result. For this example, I'll choose a limited color palette and set the number of colors in my palette to 5, and press Trace. It might take a while for the vector to render. Now that my image is vectorized, I'll press Advanced to make a few adjustments to it. I'll set my view to tracing result with outlines. This will help me to see changes I'm about to make. Back in Advanced Settings, under Path Slider, I can adjust the color shapes to be more or less detailed. I'll leave it at its default setting of 50%. The Corner Slider makes the edges of the shape smoother or sharper. When set to the maximum value, this gives the color shapes a really rough look. So we'll set the slider to 5% to smoothen them out. In the Noise Slider, I can set the minimum number of pixels for the areas that I want to be included in the vectorization process. For example, when I set it to 1 pixel, the tiniest details like pores on this apple start to appear. And if I set it to 100 pixels, those details are excluded from the final result. I'll leave it at the maximum setting. In the next panel, I can choose between two image tracing methods. When set to abutting, the color shapes are placed to one another. And when set to overlapping, larger color shapes are stacked on each other. I'll select the first method and proceed to options. The checkbox Snap Curves to Lines is selected by default. This means that curves that are close to 0 or 90 degrees get turned into straight lines. Watch what happens when I uncheck this box. The edges of my color shapes get even smoother. If your original image has a white background, you can check the box Ignore White, and the background will be removed, leaving you with just the vector of your chosen element. Even though my source image is a PNG, as you can see, the Image Trace option also includes the transparent background as an individual shape. That's why I'll make sure the box is checked, so that the background isn't included in the final result. To finish our vectorization process, I'll head over to Object, and under Image Trace, I'll select Expand. This will separate all the colored shapes on my vectorized image to their individual layers that I can edit in any way I want. For example, I can remove these white shapes from my vector. I'll choose the Direct Selection tool. Then go to Select and click on Deselect. Now I'll hover over the white spots until the path outline appears. Click to select it and press Delete twice on the keyboard. Before I export the vector, I want to scale it up. For that, I'll choose the Selection tool. Click on the layer, hold down Shift, and drag the anchor point to resize the vector. I recommend saving this as an Illustrator file, in case you need to return and change the colors of your graphic in the future. To export this vector as a PNG, I'll head over to File, Export, and Export As. A new window will open up where I'll type in a name for my image, and under Save as Type, I'll select PNG and press Export. This will open up a new window with PNG options. Here I can choose the resolution of the PNG file, as well as set the background type. Since I want to export the file with a transparent background, I need to make sure that in preview, the background color is set to transparent. Next, I'll press OK to finish exporting the file. That's all for today. Let us know if you found this video useful by leaving a like and commenting on what tutorial you'd like to see next. And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell as well to stay updated about our new videos. See you next week!